party in bullshit. All I wanna do. This party is too lit. I'm way too drunk to leave. I done bought the bus, I'm by the bed to take my keys. Turned up to the D, shouted looking right at me. Told her I'm a rich boy, I'm about to throw some D. These bitches only love you for the person that they see. Why you think I keep these BBS's all on me?
Ribs in Maldonado.
I'm good, baby. I'm good. We'll get the mic. I'm good, baby.
Yeah, hey, dog, you've been on some of everything. I mean, I remember you came to see me a couple years ago, this is 15
yeah,
and shit.
Yeah, yeah.
And at the time, you was on Survivor's Remote.
Yeah.
One of my
yeah.
favorite shows in the world. I was yeah. so mad about that last goddamn
talking
season.
About, man, I was mad too. I was hoping we got our fifth, man, but we didn't get that.
Hey, what happened to that girl with the list on there?
Man? Oh, you talking about Erica? You yeah, stay chasing.
I'm still chasing Erica, man.
Yeah, I think she's shooting the show out here. You might want to slide in them DMs, partner.
I DM'd her, but I had to stop. I was married at the time.
Oh, okay, but you good now.
Yeah, I'm cool.
You good now?
Oh, shit, that's right. You know they gonna check receipts.
Yeah.
She DM'd back.
That's
when she DM'd back because I wasn't expecting her to DM me back.
Oh, you? Oh, you wasn't?
I had to stop myself.
Oh,
this got too real.
Right, right.
Let me get back in my relationship. Yeah, when playing too much go wrong. Yo, Barry Rios, what's up, boy?
Yo, Jack, thanks for having me. I'm overdosing on estrogen.
Okay. It's a little overwhelming, right?
Oh yeah.
Hey, Barry Ribs is one of my oldest friends, man, inside of comedy. No, I don't know him like that. He's just older than everybody that I know in comedy. I'm recording this spot, right there, that's a little warm-up joke, man. Yeah.
Yo, so Barry, man, how long you been doing comedy, bro?
A little over 25 years formally, but since I'm 5 years old in class.
Right.
So we're not going to figure out how many years that is.
I'm over here. I know what he said. I ain't know what he said. I was like, wow, what?
He started when he was 80.
Okay.
5 years old in public school. I always was a funny kid.
Mm.
And if anybody out there wants to know how old I am, I'm between 50 and deceased.
That's a good range.
You remember what you was doing the day King had got assassinated?
I had nothing to do with it. I've never been to Texas.
Oh, Lord.
I love all good people.
Hey, speaking of that, you know you could play Martin Luther King if you wanted to.
Hey, man, hey, send yeah,
you have an audition.
Hey, now, I ain't auditioned for it, but they can definitely sign me up for it. I'm there.
I got a great question for you. Like, I've been to some auditions, right?
Okay.
And then you walk in and you see certain motherfuckers there, you like, let me get the fuck out of here. I don't belong here. These motherfuckers is going, I'm not finna get you. Marlon Wayans might be in there, such and such.
Yeah.
You ever been to one of those auditions?
Man, you know what? I can't recall, man. I feel like audition is a gladiating sport for me.
Mm-hmm.
So when I see like a cat that's more established than me, you know, doing something, you know, got more movies than me, I'm on my A game at that point. Like I love when I see.
Oh, you up for the dog fight?
Oh yeah, yeah. I'm a warrior. I'm a gladiator. I love to audition. Mm-hmm. So you know what I'm saying. So when I see somebody that's more established than me, like that's. that's when the fangs come out. Like, I'm ready to rock. Like, that's, oh, I'm about to.
It don't matter who it is.
It don't matter who it is.
If Denzel could walk up in that motherfucker, you still
like, I work with Denzel. I work with everybody from Denzel, Jennifer Aniston, Sir Ben Kingsley, Bradley Cooper, Gerard Butler. Like, I've, Katherine Heigl. Like, I've worked with everybody. So, like, I'm not intimidated by nobody.
What your mama say?
You know, my mama don't be giving a shit about nothing.
Like, she, give me something.
Let me tell you something. Like, she's never been excited. I tell her about all the stuff I've done. I work with all these people. The only time she got excited was with Denzel.
That's what I'm saying.
Like, with Denzel. That was it, though. I work with everybody. I said Denzel. She was like, I couldn't leave set without getting a picture with him. Like, I was done shooting. She was like, don't come home without that damn picture.
Because she wouldn't believe it.
She wouldn't let me in the house. Like, she's like, you ain't coming back in the house. So I had to wait all day for him to finish shooting. Like, I'm the fan. Like, I wasn't in the movie. Like, yo, and took a picture with him. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. He was cracking up when I told him. He was like, yo, I was like, yo, I can't get back to my mom's house.
I just wanted to ask you, because I know that you had on, like, this dope samurai suit when you were in Hong Kong. And I would love for you to talk about that.
Talk about it.
That was pretty dope. I like stuff like that, just as an actor, you being well versatile and having some skills. So tell me about those.
Yeah, things. Man. I've been training in kendo since I was 19. So people, like, on the grand, they saw me going to Japan and training. They thought it was just like a joke or something like that. And then when they see me get busy, they're like, oh, wait a minute. This ain't his first time holding a sword. So, like, I've been training. That was one of my dreams, one of my bucket lists, to go to Japan and train with an actual samurai master. And I did that. So I'm actually in training now to join the Federation and get my armor and the whole nine. That's my shit. So, that's something that I've always loved as a kid, you know what I mean?
I have a question for you. You work with a lot of actors and actresses. Do you have someone that you haven't worked with yet that you want to work with?
Oh, man, Leo. Leonardo DiCaprio.
Oh, I thought it was Leonardo from Ninja Turtles.
Hey, let me tell you something. My birthday is coming up, and I am a new character in a new Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles cartoon.
May 20th.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so I record that.
Taurus, brother.
Yeah, you already know. Taurus guy. So I actually am gonna be working with Leonardo.
That's
dope. Yeah. Is that crazy? Is that crazy?
I wanted to find out, because you're very well accomplished for your age. Thanks. And 77 film projects? I mean, come on now.
Let's do the
damn thing.
Okay. See what you're doing.
And now you have expanded yourself and your brand into doing an app to help bring short films to a whole other level and platform. What stimulated that? And tell us about that.
Okay.
The app.
Yeah, the app is called Everybody Digital. It's available on Apple and Google Play. It's for free. It's a short film streaming app. It's basically short film version of Netflix. So we produce original short films. We got one with Dion Cole on there called Why Comedians Laugh. It's his dramatic debut. Like, he's phenomenal. And we got one with Miles Brown from Narcoleptic. He's called Narcoleptic from Blackish. He's on there. We got one with that's directed by Ron Rico from Survivor's Remorse. We got a bunch of original films on there, along with a huge catalog of short films from around the world. So that all came about because I saw short films as the a genre that was the least developed. Mm-hmm. Feature films, commercials, even Instagram. You know, people are making millions of dollars from these projects. Clips. And people with short films, they just burning money away. They just throwing it in the fireplace and they ain't getting
that. That's how I feel about a short film. Why make some shit that's like 30 minutes long when you can go ahead and add 60 more pages and make a feature film?
And just shoot it. So what I'm trying to create with Everybody Digital is an actual industry for short films. And also with our app, our main direction this year is to take our short films and package them together as proof of concepts to go pitch, to turn them into features and television shows. So that's our main focus this year. So with our originals, along with some of our filmmakers, a part of the app, that's our job moving forward, is to be able to be a talent hub for all of the future filmmakers in the world, mm-hmm. where you can get your start here and we can help you transition to the next level.
You've been in a lot of different projects. People have casted you in lots of skits and whatnot.
This is true. Mm-hmm. And I'm learning there's a new game out here. It's followers, those numbers and stuff. And I was talking to somebody earlier today. It's important also to have talent. If you got the followers, I think there's a market for quality and garbage, okay?
Oh, yeah.
You're
talking about that.
Yeah. Now, I grew up on the greats. My uncle was a comic. So, even with my stand-up, I'm not a short cutter. I try to do the best I can. It is true. I've been in a short film. I've been in music videos. I have a specific look. I'm doing a feature film. I was telling somebody earlier, I asked a Facebook friend for a part in his feature and he gave it to me. Mm. No audition. Yo, this is crazy. So I think people out there should not shy away from asking. Mm-hmm. I get into a habit of asking where I have a good sense I'm going to get a yes. I also have an idea if it's going to be a no, I'm not going to be foolish either, okay?
Right.
So, in stand-up, it is very important to have people come to the clubs to see you live. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, you're just one of many stand-ups. So, coming into this new year, my goal was to get an interesting credit and or to become a draw. So I'm now in a podcast semi-regularly. I just got on Twitter for the first time. Yo, what's so funny about that? You're supposed to be my girl. Yo. Before I even tweeted, you gotta know the jargon, Jack. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like, yeah.
Before I even tweeted, one time I had 200 followers. Since I tweeted, because it's all about trying to make people laugh, which is just an instinct. You're born with that, okay? Mm-hmm. And hopefully you actually are funny. Otherwise, you look like a fool. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So now I got over 400 followers. I'm still doing stand-up all over the country. I'll be in Vegas. I'll be in Detroit. I'll be in L.A. And people go, whoa, for an older dude, man, he's inspiring and shit. Don't be judging me the way I look. I started later. I got sidetracked. And I feel blessed to be doing this career. I call it better late than never.
That's right. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. He's on the better late than never tour.
As African American, do you get typecasted a lot? And then how do you deal with that to get more serious roles?
Nah, man. I don't. I mean, this is what I always tell. I tell actors, this is a business. And for any advice for any actors out there, this is not an acting career, this is an acting small business. When you get into this game, that's what you're doing. You're not going to an interview and dropping your resume and you get a job and all of a sudden you're beginning your career and all that stuff. No. This is you investing in yourself. You gotta invest in your own marketing materials, promotional materials. You have to come up with a business plan. You have to come up with everything you would do in a small business. And with that being said, you got to know what you're selling. You got to know whether you Walmart, you Gucci, you selling soda, you selling jeans, you selling whatever. You have to
define. Selling your soul.
You know what I'm saying? For that too.
Mm-hmm.
You
got to market for that.
You have to define your product. Mm-hmm. So as every one of your favorite actors they've defined who and what type of brand they have. Like Will Smith, every film he does is the impossible. Mm-hmm. He's a superhero in every movie. Mm-hmm. He overcomes the impossible. Suit of Happiness, Bad Boys, the new one that he got coming out. Like, everything is overcome the impossible.
I saw that you're a parent. And it's difficult being in this industry, moving around so much and not being around your child.
Right.
I saw that you brought him on set with you, was it?
Yeah. Well, let me clarify that. That's my nephew. That's my nephew that I raised like my son.
Okay.
I don't have my own kids, but that's my son still. You know what I'm saying? Okay. It's definitely difficult, you know, being all over, traveling all the time, and you know, I'm raising a young man, so my influence and you know my impact is very important to him. So it's about, you know, dedicating his time, whenever I'm not on set, and then also in involving him. Like, he's always on set. He's been on set since he was 3 years old. Mm-hmm. So he know how to act. He ain't go back. He know how to act when the cameras roll.
What I was about to say, because in reference to branding and making sure you set your own lane and leaving a legacy for that child, I was going to ask you, how do you set up the child? Like, because some people, you'll put them into the acting because that's a given. What else do you set up for children? Being that you're in a position of power in some way,
right.
You leave things for the child that are there now that can build now for the child.
Right. Well, my thing is, I'll be totally honest. I would want him to do everything but acting. You know what I'm saying? Because I know what the struggle, and I know how hard it is. And if you don't love this game, don't do it.
I say that all the time when people ask me about comedy.
Don't do it.
You got to want to fucking
you
do
gotta
that.
Want. I got to be able to tell you no, and you still do it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And you still do it. That's what love is. Right. You know what I'm saying? Love will make you hard-headed.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So for me, with him, it's all about him finding what he loves. My thing is, what I do with, because I help not just raise him, but my other five nieces as well, is that I'm always watching them to see what they naturally love doing. And then as a businessman, I'm like, well, let's just figure out how to make money from it.
Right.
As simple as that. Right. It's simple, but it's also difficult in figuring out how to make money from certain things. But my inspiration is, they sold a pet rock. They sold a pet. It was the number one toy for fucking Christmas. Was a pet rock. So if they can sell a pet rock, whatever you want to do is, I'm sure, better than the damn pet rock.
This year, I did 180 degrees. I decided I want to become a road warrior. I resisted that. I didn't know if I wanted the lifestyle of packing bags, stressing at airports, hotels, the nine. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
But like I said, I'm going to Vegas. I just got back from Phoenix. I got to go back to Phoenix again towards the end of the year. I think starting this journey of being a road warrior, I have a feeling I'm going to love it. I have a feeling. As the young man, because everybody's young man or woman to me at this point.
Not you.
I forgot your name?
Alan.
Alan what?
Maldonado.
We'll stick with Alan.
Say it louder.
Alan
Maldonado. Yeah.
That's a great name. Alan Mal, that's a great name. Touching on what Jack and Alan Maldonado said. This is business show. This is not show business. I gotta wrap this shit up.
You gotta preach. Yes. No, you don't do nothing. You're making a point right now. You're making a point right now.
And I was gonna jump in when Alan said something.
Yeah.
When I started stand up formally in 94, a club owner, which will be nameless, said,
"Fuck him.
You're too old for my club." That didn't stop me.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. I have since done his club 8 times.
Come on, talk about it.
Talk about it.
Yo, like you said, Jack, being a stand-up, being an entertainer, you are called. We all are of service to one another. I was born to entertain people. Alan knows, you know, the ladies know. There's a lot of sacrifice from your personal social life when you're entertaining people.
Yeah.
That is the price you pay. Any money, fame, fortune, that's just icing on the cake.
It's extra. Right.
Yes.
Is there anything you guys want to say before we close on that tail party bullshit right now?
Man, check out season 2 of The Last OG. I got a movie with Jamie Foxx and Joseph Gordon-Levitt coming out on Netflix called Power. I got another animated cartoon on Netflix coming on called Maya and the Three.
Nice.
What
else you got? Because that sounds like a whole lot of lit.
I got more. another show called Sneakerheads. It's a scripted television series with my boy King Batch. Yeah, and I got a bunch of other stuff, but I can't speak about it.
Nice.
All right.
That shit you can't speak about.
Yeah.
I just want to hang out with Alan. That's what I want to do.
Get his number.
Thanks for having me.
Party bullshit. We out of here, man.
Yeah.
DJ, let's take a picture. Go, y'all.
Let's take a picture.